what I can tell, we're just supposed to hurry up and climb the cage. We're supposed to hurry up and climb it. Can't really. Like at times that it's going slower, it doesn't really. You know, at times it seems like it wants to burst out fast. Sometimes it just. Yeah, like look at that. I don't know, I'm supposed to climb the cage and it's not like. That is unrealistic. You don't want to climb that cage that quick. Look at that. I can't climb a cage that fast. Really expect you to. That's the only conclusion I can come up with. Nothing else is in the room. And then I'm noticing sometimes it wants to, like the hoop or the shield, it grows back faster at times, and other times it doesn't. So I wonder if that's determined by how far you are. Oh. There's literally no way you can get there. Yeah, see, like now, look. But look at that. It was growing back slow, slow. But I can't do anything. I just don't know how did anybody climb this thing. There's no way I can get that. There's no way I can climb that fast. Now, come on, man. There gotta be some way to slow that stuff down besides. There gotta be some way to slow it down. There's literally nothing you can do to go up against something going back that fast. You don't even have enough time to get halfway up the cage, let alone up it. Make it seem like you got enough time to climb the whole thing like fast. Well, you don't have enough time. No matter how fast you're moving, you don't have enough time to. Like, I think the longer I hold it down. Wow. Yeah, I couldn't do anything to stop it. I had to expect you to climb something like that fast. I think you. Stupid, man. You don't have enough time to move. Don't have enough time to move. Man, is that giving me enough time? I don't know how to do this. Bro, I can't. It's not going back slow at all. It's just. How the hell am I supposed to hit? This is impossible. Like, this is something I gotta do to slow it down some other way. I can't do that. There's something you can do to, I don't know, maybe. That's all. Oh, wait. There we go. Was debris. All they had to think to do is to destroy the rest of that stuff. Uh-oh. Oh shit, we got trouble. Oh, in the cavalry. That's what that was. Oh, wow. So he was actually supposed to put. So that whole time. So that little boy was supposed to be sacrificed to a machine, and they were supposed to put some goop out, and that's what he's been eating the whole time? What the heck? Dude. You snap. That is crazy, though. What a horrible plot twist. Where the fuck did the shield roll off to? Don't know what the hell I'm supposed to do. It's a lot of them over here. How the hell am I supposed to respond to this the whole time they were feeding them liquefied humans? Oh, that's it right there. And just supposed to hold on for dear life? We ever gonna land? What the heck? Oh man. That's still the poster. Here it is. I'd be surprised if I gotta start up the engine again. Don't work like that no more. Yeah, where the hell did it go? Oh, did it disappear? Wait, what? Where the hell did the tail go? What's down there? you doing all that doesn't do a damn thing. What the hell, they all committing suicide now? What is this? Falling off. That was it. It'd be funny if you put him in like a cannon and just shot him back to his village. Well, now they're gonna fly him back. All right, wishful thinking. I still like the cannon idea though. So even though we got that, where did the, like, how was that master of the valley? Or informed. Exactly how long has this boy been gone? A month? Months? Year? But that one lazy eye, he almost looks drunk.
アジュクイ、アティスネキャタギ。
That's it, man. That's the last Guardian. Same people that created the whole galaxy. Man, this is one hell of a story. That plot twist at the end. They found out that I guess this has been happening in their village for quite some time. Those beasts show up, kidnap some of the villagers, swallow them. And while they're ingested, they create these markings on their villager's body. And then they go puffle up into like the statue that turns them into those barrels that I was feeding the whole time. So that's kind of like, man, kind of saddening when you think about it. Most definitely, man, the story was good. Really, I had no problems with the game. The only complaint would be that the movement of the game, it could have been tightened up. So it was plenty of times, as I'm pretty sure y'all seen throughout this playthrough, where the movement mechanics were kind of like messed up. It was like at times, it would just happen randomly. Like you would be running, and all of a sudden, you know, to just stop and start running great speed, which I don't think we ever got his name or why the Master of the Valley was even like created. How did that tower even get there? The starters, because it looked like it wasn't there naturally. Or what happened to the rest of the other that were in that place? Yeah, man, it was just some stuff that just didn't add up. And that was clearly one of them. Like the movie mechanics didn't, like, it never explained what his name was or what the village was or why the beast came there to take them away, sacrifice them to that, whatever the hell that thing was, Master of the Valley, turn them into goo. Like, obviously, it was made to, to get the machine powered, but. Explain is how come those glass eyes was causing him to not, move. Like what was about him that made him so afraid of him? Or like what? Like that was never explained. Like I guess in a game where they don't do communicating like you would normally find in other games, certain things are just aren't going to be explained. This was basically pretty much just communicating through body language more than anything. So, like, there's only so much you can get out of that. But, like I said, my only complaint was what was the movement? Because they could have sharpened that up to where you can get consistent movement how you wanted it. Like, if I'm running, I didn't want to stop and start running in place or. Because that messed me up a couple times. But that's really my only complaint. Other than that, man, I don't have no problem with the game. I think if anybody like games such as Ico or like, puzzle platformer style games, this definitely is right there up your alley. So, honestly, I think it was great. Everything was good besides the movement mechanics and those few questions that left unanswered. Who was his name? Why did the beast go to that village to kill him? Where did that Master of the Valley came from? Why were they stealing? Like, I know why, but, I don't know. Like, exactly what were those markings? Like, it's a bunch of questions that just went unanswered, but I kind of understand why they weren't answered. Because there's really no way to answer them when the game is designed like this. But I would still like to know. I don't know, like maybe we can ask the developers, like, or something. Maybe we can find out from him. Other than that, man. Like, who is that statue? Like, where did this mirror come from? That's another question. So many questions, so few answers. But I like the game. I like it. Like, it could have been better in some areas, but other than that, I liked it. So it was cool for what it was. Yeah, let's skip this. What else they got? And that's it. So, hope you guys enjoyed this playthrough of The Last Guardian. I know I enjoyed it for the most part. I will see you guys next time for more playthroughs here on ADS Play 101. Until then.